Welcome to Planet Bollywood. Almost a month ago, Tanushree Dutta first spoke up right here on Planet Bollywood and the Me Too movement hit India. The Me Too wave hit India. And since then, we on Zoom have started this campaign, hashtag We Are Listening. And it's only been possible because the brave women have stepped forward and fearlessly named and shamed the harassers. And one such lady is right here with us. Thank you for joining, Mandana. Thank you for joining us on Planet Bollywood.
Thank you for having me.
You've shared your story. We've all read it. But for the ones who don't know yet, you've named Sajid Khan, you've named Umesh, and for the ones who don't know it yet, could you please take this platform and let us know what happened?
The incident that I had with Sajid was around 4 years ago when they were casting for Hamshikal film, and me and my manager, we went to the office to have the initial meetings. That was when he had all my pictures, you know, in bikini or in Indian avatar and all that. But then the next thing I hear from him is that, you know, in my set is a very friendly set, and I get very close to my actors, and you know, I treat them like family, and we are all very close, and especially for this character that I'm casting, I need to see, how your body is.
Yeah.
So I said, I don't understand, but you have my pictures. And he's like, no, I need to see it. And, you know, until you don't see it with your own eyes, how are you going to believe it? And also, like, you seem like you're not wearing enough makeup. You have a dark circle. And, you know, I want to also, like, check how your body is and all that. And and yet, I wasn't used to the whole thing which happens with a lot of girls, you know, the casting couch, as we talk about.
Yeah.
Or like the creepy guys who are asking you to sleep with them. And I've heard it before, that especially when you're not from India, when you're a foreigner, when you're coming from another country, it's like you don't have the, you know, the boyfriend who's taking care of you.
Or
you know,
the
you
family.
Need the family, or you need this man to support you and, you know, make sure that no one can actually talk to you in so-and-so manners. But I never believed actually it's happening. You know, it's more like a gossip. You know it's happening, but you're not sure. And then I told my manager, I said, listen, if you have a job, if you have a film, that they want to take me as who I am and as an actor, and I don't mind doing my job, but I'm not going to do what is the other stuff, which is, oh, if you don't sleep with me, I'm not going to sign you. I'm not going to do that part. And it was very clear. And, you know, it's kind of weird when your manager says, you know, you need to be a little bit more softer. You need to be a little bit more, what's the word? A little bit easy. A little bit easy. People, they don't like to see someone like who's so opinion on everything. Don't talk. You know, let them talk and let them be more like guiding you towards it. Don't say anything. And I did struggle in my life, you know, with that, because I've stayed here for almost 8 years now. And I did struggle. I was trying to fit in. You know, when you're trying to fit in a society, when you're trying to fit in a new work environment, right, you kind of start, like, thinking, okay, wait a minute. Is this how it works? Maybe actually I should give it a try. But no, that's not me. But how that's going to work? You know, how that's going to work, that you're going to make the director feel like, okay, I'm going to sleep with him.
Yeah.
But until I'm going to sign it, I'm going to play that role. But then the moment I sign it, then, oh, yay.
Yeah.
But that's not a point. The point is the harassment even starts after that.
Yeah.
It's a never-ending story. I moved on with life. And finally, I got a big film, which was Ekta's film, Balaji, Kya Kula Ham Tri. And Ekta knew that she wanted me in a moment that she saw some stuff that I was done in Randi Huda's film. So she knew that she wanted me in Kya Kul. And that was very clear. I went to office, we signed the papers and everything. But the moment that I met my director for first time, first of all, he seemed sweet, but off sweet. Because then later he said, oh, you need to do some screen test. So I said, I'm already on board for the film.
The producers hired me.
Yeah. It's, you know. And he says, you know what, I didn't want you here, and I'm a director. And I had someone else who's Indian and who's way better an actress than you, and then she was this and she was that. So he's going on and on and on about probably his girlfriend or whoever he wanted for a film. Anyhow, he calls it the look test for the film, which I never wore any of those stuff for a film.
Okay.
And so I started doing screen tests. I'm going to office every day. And then he's talking about, like, I'm some extra person there. I don't even exist. Or I do exist, but I need to be so thankful to him that accept the accept me as an actress on that set.
Yeah.
Because it's so weird, because if your producer has signed you, you're already getting money. And my producer was a woman.
Yeah.
You know, it wasn't like, oh, I slept with someone and I got into a film. No, I was a woman who liked me for who I am and how I look. And it worked for her and she wanted me in the film, right?
And we're talking about the director, Umesh Ghadke here,
yes.
of Kya Cool Hai Hum 3. Just
yes.
for our viewers to know
yes.
that. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
And anyhow, we had a different location. The location was in Thailand. We moved there and I told them before, I'm not a good dancer. And in this film, I had two songs and my major songs with Tushar, which was a love song.
Yeah.
It had a lot of dancing step and Ekta told me before. And I told my director, you need to give me like a couple of days of practice at least. He said, yeah, don't worry. We give you time or practice or whatsoever. So we go to Thailand. After, I think, 3 days, they say, oh, we're shooting a song.
Mm.
And I'm like, sir, I need practices. No, I need you on set. You have to be on set. So I go on set from morning to evening while Tushar has half day off because he's practicing for a song. And I'm doing nothing on set, just waiting all day. And the location was far away from hotel. I reached my hotel, I think, by 10 or maybe 11 or maybe a little bit earlier. And I get like a couple of hours of practice. And Tushar is already tired. And the steps that they've given, it's for someone who's like dancer. And I'm not a dancer, right?
Yeah.
And the moment I say something to the choreographer, because everyone was there, and the director is like, see, I told you, you're not good for this film.
Mm.
See, the other girls, they can do it. And then we had another girl in the film, which she was playing one of the characters.
Yeah.
She's a dancer.
Okay.
She's a dancer, and she was hired in this film as doing one of the characters in the film. And I'm not a dancer, right?
Right.
And it doesn't mean that I'm not good at my work. I just need more practice and
no.
time, right?
Yeah.
Anyhow, I'm in so much pressure and I'm so stressed out. I'm not getting the step, they're not changing it. It's all happening, right? And also before that I was so excited because this was a big film for me.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the movie didn't do well. All that, it's none of my business. For me as a person, as an actress who came to India and who struggled for so many years for auditions and trying to meet people, and I didn't want to be with
directors. Working with Balaji is a big thing.
Yeah, and it was a big thing for me, you know?
Yeah.
And suddenly I'm just so stressed out.
Mm.
And that time, my ex-husband, my boyfriend, so I call him and I say, listen, I can't stay here anymore. I can't do this, you know? I don't think it's possible because the way he's talking, and I know where he's coming from.
Mm.
And I've even told him that, sir, the team that who's working on your movie, it's my boyfriend's company, the post-production.
Mm.
And he didn't even back off after that. You know, he was so adamant at getting what he wanted. And he said, my ex said, you know, I'll book your ticket. You're coming back to Mumbai. You're not working like this.
No.
So anyhow, I come back to Mumbai. I went to Ekta's house and I spoke to her mother and herself. And they were really upset. You know, they were very supportive and they were like, you know, this shouldn't happen on our set.
Mm.
And they did take action right away. I had lunch also with the team in Mumbai. Mm.
What did exactly Ekta Kapoor do?
So basically what they did, they were quite shocked and taken. And they had a little bit doubt of maybe like I've overreacted to it.
Okay.
But apparently they've heard on set that yes, because my ex's team were there who was doing the post-production.
Right.
And they were like, yeah, sir, is Thorasa, you know, he's kind of troubling Mandana by not giving practice time, by calling her on set and making her wait and asking her, like, change clothes,
yeah.
change looks, all that. And so anyway, what Ekta did was, there was this one person from Mumbai, he flown with me as well. And then he was my one point contact with the director.
Okay.
And I went back, but it didn't stop. It didn't end there.
Mm.
When I went back, actually everything became worse because now I've spoken about it.
Mm-hmm.
I've told the producer that he's been torturing me
yeah.
and like harassing me, right?
Yeah.
Now it's even worse.
Mm.
And after like 20 days, 25 days, everyone's like just fed up with this whole thing. They're like, just like, give it to him, yeah.
Mm.
And every single day, I'm miserable.
Mm.
I'm shooting a comedy film
yeah.
in a beautiful location with... For the first time, I have this hair team, I have makeup team, I have styling team, I have all that, right? Because
mm-hmm.
any girls who wants to become actress, right, you know.
Yeah.
You know, you want all that. You
yeah.
want to be important and said, I have all that, but I'm so miserable. I'm so miserable that I'm making my co-star miserable. I'm making the other people miserable. Mm. Actually, the only person, and I want to say this, I really appreciate her, and she was so supportive in those times, was Aftab's wife.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And because she was there with us at the hotel and, you know, all the time traveling with us. And I had this conversation, intense conversation with her, and she said, you know, I don't understand how these girls actually can be like this, you know, because the other girls in our set were okay with it. Mm-hmm. They were hanging out with everyone, bringing cake for the director, going for dinners, going for parties, hanging out. And what I want to do, finish my work, go back to my hotel and do my things. And if I would like to hang out with you, yeah, sure, great. Yeah.
It's
you know, it's my call.
That's your call.
But if it's going to be forced and if it's going to be like, oh, no. And by the way, the song that I'm talking about, it became a group song. Okay. And it wasn't anymore
your solo song.
My solo song with Tushar. And the other girls who were like with us, they were pushed more into the film and they had more scene and all that happened.
But Mandana, all this was indirectly harassing you. You know, calling you early on set and all of that.
Yeah.
But did director Umesh Ghatke at any point directly tell
approached you?
Approached
like
you inappropriately?
Oh, yeah. That's the reason I went back to Mumbai. Because
what did he exactly what exactly happened that time? What did he
so
say
what
to
happened
you?
Is my most of my my clothes, because the stylist was changed while we were in Mumbai, it wasn't bought yet, so we had to do the looks in Thailand. So when we go to Thailand, the stylist comes with bikinis or whatever, all the options. So the bikinis that I get, first of all, it's G-string, and he's asking me I should go to his room and try these bikinis and show it to him, which I said, sir, those bikinis, it doesn't even match my character. I understand you're the director. And he said, no, I want to see it on your body.
Why?
And I'm like, no, sir, but if it's orange, it's not the color that we are supposed to use for a film. Why should I try the orange and show it to you, right? Mm. If you want me to try, I try the yellow, but there is no orange in the film, so why do you want me to? No, I'm a director. You know my job also. And he started arguing with me over this, and I was like, no, I'm not coming to your room.
No.
Right.
That was the point. That was the point that trying the outfits in front of him. I mean, why there is a stylist, right?
Mm.
What's the stylist's job?
Exactly.
Yeah. Okay, so I just want to ask you one thing that you know, when you were on the set, Tushar was there.
Yeah.
Aftab was there.
Yeah.
I mean, many of the actors were there. Aapne kisi se baat ki, because Tushar is the brother of Ekta Kapoor, right? Like, did anyone, aapne baat ki kisi se, kya unhone react kara is baat pe, that why are you like?
I tell you one thing, it's very common here. It's, we know what everyone is getting through. On set, because you shoot with people for 40 days, 30 days, and you know exactly what's going on set, right? The sad part is, no one takes action against it.
Mm.
And the first thing, the first comment is, "Arey heroine to itna natak kar rahi hai yaar, kya karte? Gosh, she's so much of drama, so much of natak. At least heroine banno pehle, become a heroine and then throw the natak."
So if she's cooperating, she's good. If she's not ready to like, you know, do what you want, she's like full on natanki.
Yes, And the first person is judged is the actress.
You know, Mandana, you spoke about how the director actually called you to his room, asked you to be in a G-string and do numerous changes, which wasn't required. And after you complained, why do you think was he not replaced in the film or asked to step down? Or why wasn't any strong action taken by the producers of the film?
I don't know. I don't know why they didn't remove him. I don't know why no one stood up for me. I don't know that. The only person I had actually was my ex-boyfriend, you know, who was like, I was talking to him and he kept saying that it's okay, it's your job, finish your job, you have promised, you have signed a contract, finish it and just come home, you know.
Right.
And that's the sad part, that it has been many years. I'm sure many, many girls, they've gone through the same thing. You know, the director hasn't been removed, or they're still working.
Yeah.
And as we stand today, where you've already spoken up and you've shared your story now, has Ekta Kapoor or anybody from that team gotten in touch with you directly?
No.
Or lauded your courage for speaking up now?
I don't understand why Ekta hasn't commented on anything. Or I don't want her support. I don't want anyone's support. You know, I've done what I've done for myself, and if one person gonna watch this video or my interviews and gonna think like, okay, people are talking, I'm gonna talk about it. You know, if someone gonna get courage to talk about it, I'm happy. I don't want anyone's support. But what I'm saying is that it's sad, a woman like Ekta, who's so strong, who's millions of girls in this country, they look up to her.
Absolutely.
You know, she's a hero of a lot of girls, right? Yeah. Because if she could be so strong, a lot of girls are also like, you know, looking up to her. Yeah. Why she hasn't spoken about anything? Not about me, not coming up and supporting, no.
For the girls who are trying to be strong and trying to speak up.
Well, have you got any kind of support from the industry after, like, you've said?
Well, I've got a lot of messages. I've got a lot of couple of girls who are working already. And, you know, one of the girls, the sad part is, I feel sad for my friends because she says, this is her exact line. You know, babe, I've got like a couple of movies happening and I'm really happy how things are working for me in industry. So I don't want to piss off anyone and, you know, lose on jobs. And I'm okay now. I know a lot of shit happening. I've gone through with this guy and that guy. And she's going on and on about numbers. Yeah. And I'm like, oh, well, I don't have any more fingers.
Right.
And they're not talking about it because they're happy with their work and that works for them. But it doesn't work for me, so.
That's the harsh reality of Bollywood.
Yep.
Now, when you have the time to come up, speak, because we are listening, you don't want to talk.
Right. We must urge these women who haven't found their voices yet to come up and speak.
So, Mandana, like you said, you know, you were sharing the story with your husband, that casting directors and all, they used to come. So was it a case of sexual exploitation?
Yeah, of course it was, because but the only thing is I can't tolerate it. I can't tolerate the fact that I see these foreigners, you know, who are not even foreigners, girls who come from Bangalore or they come from south to Mumbai to
from different
make
cities
it
of India.
From different cities of India. And it's happening in front of me. I couldn't accept that. I couldn't agree to it. If something like this is happening, I would like not to have it in my house. You know, one thing I really want to mention in this part is that why, as a foreigner, as anyone who's an outsider, why do we need to sleep to get work? Why I'm not good enough for any job, but I'm good enough when I do sleep with someone, then you get the job. Mm. Why can't we have a safe and a happy place which people actually are doing their job?
Right.
You know?
This needs to stop, definitely. For the women who haven't found their voices yet, do you have a direct message to tell them? What would you like to tell them after your experience and after what you've seen?
Things are changing, hopefully. And I hope there are more people coming front and like talking. Yeah. And actually, my straight message is to those people who have messaged me on my Instagram and Twitter, on my private messages. Mm-hmm. Don't message me. Come and talk.
Right.
By messaging me, you're not going to do anything. You're a loser. Yeah. You might have the fancy car. You might signing your next big films and doing I'm working a lot. But you're a loser.
Mm-hmm.
It's and messaging me and saying that, oh my God, you're so brave to talk about it. And I mean, sorry, I don't want to even be your friend. Don't message me.
Because this is the time. It's time we speak up. And this is the time we are listening. So please, all the women, all the men who face harassment, exploitation, please speak up. It is time we name and shame them. And thank you, Mandana, for doing this. And thank you for sharing your story with us.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.